It's nice to do a book launch in a bookstore.
Yeah, I always try and go to bookstores as far as possible. So you need to support it.
Yeah.
And this is where you encourage new readers to come in.
Correct.
New readers come in, it's good for everyone.
Exactly.
Listen, thank you so much for doing this
one.
I really appreciate this. And
so this trailer you've shot particularly for the book?
Yeah. I make trailers for all my books.
Okay.
And it helps push it beyond the traditional readers also.
And who shot it?
We had a guy called Karthik and an agency called Sideways.
Okay. Who do book trailers basically?
No, they're a proper ad agency. Started by a Cannes Award winning guy.
Okay.
Ogilvy.
Okay.
Yeah,
whenever you're there.
Seven guys.
Guys, we are all starting in say less than 30 seconds. So once the video starts, we'll request everybody to keep quiet. Media questions will only happen once the live is over, the Facebook live is over, which will give you a cue, which Amish will give you a cue on. Okay.
Correct.
You can just on it.
Is my mic working? The odd pause.
Now is the view clear?
What I'm doing in this is from the birth of Ram to the kidnapping of Sita. The first book.
Correct.
The second book is from the birth of
Sita to the kidnapping of Sita.
The third book is from the birth of Ram to the kidnapping of Sita. Three
different. Nice.
Yeah.
And then?
Fourth book onwards is comic.
What happens after that? Of course.
Nice.
We all know that.
Nice. No, very nice. The book was also good. Once again, I'm with the beautiful Alia out here. She's still as beautiful as she was 5 minutes ago. And we are going to speak of Sita, Warrior of Mithila. As you all know, it's the second book of the Ramchandra series, the sequel to Sign of Ikshvaku. And this is a very different perspective on Sita Maa, at least different from what we modern urban Indians are used to. It's truer to her ancient versions. She's a warrior in this, as is obvious from the title and the cover, as you can see out here. So, in this program, what we're going to do is, since we're going to launch the trailer, we're going to show the trailer exclusive only to Alia. You guys don't get to see it right now, sorry.
Special privilege.
Special privilege. But the trailer will be shown to all of you guys at the end of this Facebook Live. I'm going to show the trailer to you and then we'll have a chat. We'll have some question answers between us. And then, of course, then the trailer gets shown to you. So here we go. This is the... it's an apple, which I'm not used to. Sorry.
Adopted daughter who trained to be a fierce warrior, ruled as an able prime minister, and was destined to be a goddess.
But I can clap. It's lovely.
Thank you. The model who acted that last shot, I know I'm teasing you guys. You guys will see it at the end. The last shot, the model actually acted out the shot that you see on the cover.
No, as I
brilliant.
Saw here right now.
Brilliant.
No, it's lovely. It's so different.
And
it's lovely.
Even the model out there, you know, you could make out he's a fierce warrior. Iske saath pange mat lo.
Yeah,
so,
definitely. मैं तो नहीं जा रही हूँ जंगल
में। Okay, so that's the trailer, and we're going to show you the trailer at the end of the Facebook Live. But now there's a time for a chat between Alia and me. Since I'm the host, I get to ask the first question.
Why? Okay, first
okay,
let's discuss
okay.
what we're going to be talking
okay.
about.
Some stuff which I want to know.
Yeah.
About the world that I don't know about.
And some stuff that I want to know.
Correct. About stuff that hopefully I can answer. So, I don't know the glamour world well, okay? I'm an author and before that I was in financial services for 14 years, as drab and boring as they come. So, don't laugh when I ask this question.
Okay.
What is this airport look? Ye kya hota hai?
Okay, first let's say, right now we're going to be bursting all the myths.
Okay.
So I'm going to be asking you questions and you can burst my myths.
Okay.
And now you want to know about airport looks,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Airport look is your look when you're going to the airport.
Which is comfortable.
It's comfortable, but it has to be fashionable. Because while you're strutting down the airport, it's almost like you're strutting down the ramp.
Okay.
So why shouldn't you be fashionable? That's all the airport look is about.
It's a little bizarre.
But actually now it's gone to another spectrum altogether. It's no longer airport look. It's coming out of restaurant look. It's going into gym look. It's coming out of house look. It's going into restaurant look. So basically there always has to be a look.
You know, I had my most bizarre experience. You know, I don't attend too many pastry parties or anything, but I attended Karan's birthday party. And that was a red carpet thing. I'm not
this
used to
page
it.
3 party is another problem.
Okay.
What do you mean by page 3
okay,
party?
Okay, sorry, I take that back. But I attended this party. It was a red carpet thing. And one of the few times I attended one. And I entered, and this journalist came up with a camera in tow, thrust the mic on my face and said, "Who are you wearing?" I thought maybe her English isn't good or something. So I said, "I'm sure you meant what are you wearing?"
No.
And I said, "I'm wearing a pair of jeans and a jacket." No, I didn't know I'm supposed to answer what designer. I'm an author, yeah. If my trousers and socks match, that's good enough.
That's okay. But you can be wearing, like, I wear Topshop or, you know, H&M. It doesn't have to be like Dior. It can be anything.
Okay,
basically,
no
who are we wearing? We want to know so that we can put this lip together if we want to.
Okay, so something I've learned. Your turn.
My turn?
Your turn.
Okay, so I heard that, at least that's the way I imagine it, that when writers write, they like lock themselves up in a room and, you know, they don't talk to anybody and it's
grow
like, you know, grow their beard and they're very antisocial because once you're writing, you're writing.
Okay.
And there's something called like a writer's block and you don't want to reach that block. So tell me, is it true like when you write, are you not like able to socialize? Do you have to put your phone off? Do you have to disconnect? What is it like? I'm sure it's different for everybody, but I want to know from you.
One of the good things about being a writer is you can get away with a lot of shit because you can pretend that, oh, I'm this writer type and, you know, I'm not gonna do all this and people expect
so
it.
So you use it as an excuse.
Exactly. I'll tell you what I need for my writing. I party more with my family and close friends. I don't really go for too many parties. But while writing, what I need, I listen to music while writing. I always need music. It works
okay.
like a key. So any genre.
And do you
music.
Have like a special time in the day? Like you can only write in the morning or you can only write in the night? Like there are some people who can only make music in the night.
No, I'm normally a morning person. After 9:30, 10, my brain stops working. I'm normally asleep by 10:30, 11. Yeah.
Lovely.
Boring,
and wake
sorry.
Up at?
5:30 normally. I'm a morning guy.
Kuch to seekho, wow. I would love to wake up at 5:30, but absolutely. Even if I sleep at 10:30, I'll wake up at 10:30.
My wife works better at night. So, you know, if she has to do something important, she'll stay up till late. So what happens sometimes is if she has some important work and I have important work, she'll be up till 4 o'clock and she'll be coming back and I'll wake up and, you know, so we run into each other.
This is called equality. It's balancing out. Great. Love it.
And I eat a lot of cream biscuits while writing. That always works. Music, cream biscuits. I tend to put on weight. My turn.
Yes.
Okay. This is a question which I had thought of and I thought it'll be